Great,
So
great,
already
great.
has a account. In fact, even he's
Oh.
the first one to like BTTC posts also.
We are
Oh
already live
my.
on
We are live,
YouTube.
please, yeah.
Please start.
Good morning to one and all. I welcome all the principals and in all my fellow colleagues and students for the fifth day of our webinar series on digital content creation for social media. Online has become the default mode of education during this long lockdown period in the wake of COVID-19. What does this mean for the institution, academic leaders, administrators, and students in the long run is getting clearer. Among many economic sectors, the higher education sector is undergoing a tectonic shift right now. What several futuristic and education technologists have been forecasting for long is now happening. In the wake of COVID-19 pandemic, millions of students across the globe have been driven out of their university space, and professors are confined to their homes. Higher education stands disaggregated, and faculty and students are grappling with the sudden new norm of completely tech-mediated teaching and learning. Taking this challenge as an opportunity to reach out to the society and student community, Dr. Balani, in charge principal of Bombay Teachers Training College, HSNC University, Mumbai, and Dr. G.B. Thambi, principal of Thadomal Shahani Engineering College, Mumbai, collaboratively organized this webinar series from 6th July to 11th July. Today is the fifth day of this webinar series. Let's begin the session with the blessings of Almighty with college prayer. Subhia, before beginning today's session on Instagram Masterclass, let me show you glimpses of yesterday's session on magazine design and infographics by Professor Monica Tolani and her team of students from Thadomal Shahani Engineering College. Miss Monica Tolani gave an insight on magazine design and infographics. She gave an introduction to the magazine, types of magazine, tips for designing an effective magazine, introduction to infographics and why infographics are important, and how to organize information with infographic and type of infographic. Further, the session got continued with the topic on magazine creation and infographics and was explained by Mr. Girish Chawla. He explained in detail about InDesign software of Adobe family. He compared CorelDRAW and InDesign. He explained user interface, adding pictures, text, shape, images, text wrap, adding page numbers to the document, adding colors, and how to create a table, etc. Today, we have with us Dr. Bhavana Rajpal for the fifth day taking session on Instagram Masterclass. The idea of projecting college education to the target student population using social media is not a new phenomenon. As many educational institutions regularly communicate to the public via their social media pages. In fact, rather than the standard advertisement, digital advertising would capture many eyeballs. Instagram stands to score here as the present generation prefers visual cues to text. Starting a new educational institute on a new course in an existing institute requires the reach of the student population who would any day prefer social media to the mainstream media. putting up a new Instagram story along with other media advertisement would attract a lot of attention and would ensure the marketing goals are reached. Today, social media such as Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram have become primary source of information. They are also vehicles for fake news and disinformation. During a crisis like the COVID-19 pandemic, how should social media be mastered and employed in a responsible way? I'm sure today's session will enlighten on this. I call upon Sabil Sheikh to introduce today's resource person, Ms. Bhavana Rajpal. Over to Sabil.
Thank you, ma'am. A very good morning to one and all. By the blessings of our esteemed principal, Dr. Bhagwan Balani sir, our professors, and entire family of Bombay Teachers Training College, I, Sabil Sheikh, would like to take the opportunity to introduce today's webinar on digital content creation for social media. With the development of science and technology, our life relies on digital products much more than previous decades. Digital activities have been helping us in many fields, ranging from scientific research to school learning. Social media is a fantastic way to get expressed to people to express themselves, whether via Facebook status, writing on walls, Twitter tweets, Instagram stories, or YouTube channel. These all are extensions of you and your personality. I'd like to extend a special welcome to our resource person, the Sindhi girl, Ms. Bhavana Rajpal. Ms. Bhavana wears many hats of success. She has been an ardent researcher on Sindhi cinema of India. For the same, she also curated and organized the first ever Sindhi film festival in London. Post that, she has been invited to Paris, Beirut, Warsaw at various international conferences to present her work and share her knowledge on Sindhi cinema. Her media interviews with BBC London, Eastern Eye, Sindhian tell us the importance of sheer hard work and dedication. To reach a wider audience, 2 years ago, Ms. Bhavana chose to expand the Sindhi Film Festival on digital medium. 2 years over, 100 YouTube videos later, her YouTube channel amassed over 1 lakh total views. Her YouTube channel titled Sindhi Film Festival is a database of all Sindhi things. Walls, interviews, cultural food, Sindhi English books, and many more. With the help of Instagram and YouTube, she has successfully managed to reach Sindhis across all over the world. Miss Bhavana, Sindhiya Jelai, Jam Sutho Kam Kari Thi, Jule Lal Kare, Tava Ke Dadi Suthi Zindagi De. Now, I would like to hand over the session to Ms. Bhavana Rajpal. Thank you.
Sabil, that was so impressive. I like people who put in efforts. You spoke in Sindhi. Thank you. Thank you. Firstly, thanks to Professor Dr. Bhagwan Balani for having me and trusting me enough to do these master classes. I hope I impress you enough. So I want to begin by telling you all a little bit about myself. Can we please share the screen? Okay, because I'm the co-host, I can. Here it is. A little bit of heads up would be good. If you all can see my screen, please tell me now. People, you all can see my screen?
Yeah.
Yes. Oh,
okay, thank you, fantastic. Welcome to my studio. I wish I was in Thadomal Shahani or BTTC premises right now, but it's okay, we'll make this work. So why am I doing this masterclass with y'all? Since about 5 years, I have been an ardent Instagram user. And when you do something every day for a lot of time, you become better at it. I'm going to share a few tips and tricks with y'all, but also tell y'all the basics about Instagram. And I want to tell y'all why I am doing what I'm doing. So social media is one of my favorite ways to express myself. And I believe, like Sabil said in her introduction for me, that it is an extension of ourselves. I am a social to people, and I like expressing through photos and videos. about a year ago, because I do a lot of Sindhi related stuff and my English happens to be really good, I was selected to be the digital media manager for Jhulelal Teerathdham. Now, Jhulelal Teerathdham is a huge project and they had no online presence. So I pitched in what I would do for them and they selected me. I have my own in-house team of video people, photo people, editors, everything. So we manage a lot of different Instagram accounts. I cannot tell you the names of others because of privacy reasons. This is one which is a public religious place. And I'm very proud to tell you all that the phase one launch was very good and they are very happy with the services they've provided. Now, moving on from my background to what I currently also do among many other things, I would first like to ask y'all if everybody has an Instagram account. This is going to be a very hands-on situation, hands-on masterclass. If y'all do, can y'all please go to Sindhi Film Festival, no spaces, I've written the name on my slides, at Sindhi Film Festival. And if y'all can follow me, I'll tell y'all why I'm requesting you to follow me. Y'all can unfollow later, don't worry. So this is our channel, Sindhi Film Festival. This is our Insta handle, Sindhi Film Festival. Y'all can see the stories that we've posted yesterday. And even now I have posted that we have begun the session. We are ready to roll and all of that. So if y'all start following me there, y'all will be able to see a lot more hands-on what I'm going to show you further throughout the session now. That was my intro. That was my handle name. I hope you all are up to date with me. Now I'm going to start with the absolute basics. Instagram is a visual medium. It is all about photos and videos. And we have to understand that in life, our eyes are trained to appreciate things that look good. And by good, I'm not talking about extremely aesthetic pictures, very beautifully edited pictures. No, I'm just talking about simple, basic, good lighting, good angles, two things. These are the two things that I always teach my team people to focus on. You cannot have a bad lighting photo. Even the photo which is black and white or which is apparently looking dark, dim, that has also been edited if you follow some good photographers. I follow photographers. I follow a lot of accounts which are university based because I'm very interested in knowing what everybody is doing, how are they doing it, and to just learn from experience, because the more you know, the more you read, the better you become as a writer. It's as simple as that. So I'm going to talk to y'all about the visual appeal, and I'm going to first cover the absolute basics in the next 30 to 40 minutes, just to give you a schedule of the class today. In the next 30 to 40 minutes, I'll be covering the basics. I'll talk to you about how to click a good photo with whatever phone you have. The phone does not matter because it is a lot about how you click the picture. So the angles, the lighting, and absolute basic editing. These are the three things that I'm going to cover in the next 30 to 40 minutes. Then I'm going to have a quick chat with the two girls who handle BTTC Instagram account because I want to know their experiences and their questions. After we do that, I'm going to have a little Q&A. Then the tips and tricks and the closing, during the closing, I'll tell you a few apps which are going to just transform your life. So let's get started. The first thing is light. I hope you all have followed me right now on Sindhi Film Festival Instagram account. I'm going to be posting a picture now, which I'll show you how it matters so much. Right now, the way you all can see me is this, right? My camera is on my eye angle. I'll talk about that further in angles. But right now I have a ring light behind my laptop, which is focusing its light directly on my face, okay? And I'm just going to switch off that ring light button. And this is how it looks without the light focusing on my face. There are three tube lights here in my studio. They are all on. But still, when you want to focus on something, make sure there is enough light on that. Again, to talk about this further, to show you this further, I'm just going to post a picture without ring light. Right now, I'm clicking the photo and posting it on my Insta, Sindhi Film Festival Instagram. And then with the ring light, as you all can see, I'm clicking another picture and you all will be able to see the difference. Okay, so at Sindhi Film Festival Instagram, both the pictures are going up. All right, so this is the absolute basic. When you want to click a picture of something, you have to make sure that it is well lit. And sometimes people do the mistake of burning the photos. Sometimes you can have too much light. Even right now, my ring light has an intensity button. So from 10% to 100%. I've kept it somewhere in the middle because when I keep it on 100%, it just becomes too much. And even I can't take it. I can't see anything because there's too much light. So make sure you don't overdo it. Make sure you don't underdo it. Be in the middle and do not click pictures without good lighting. Just do not click it, please. If you're going to post something, make sure that Instagram statistics know that your pictures are good. Instagram also has a memory of its own. So the more you post, the more you become organically widespread. Your profile becomes organically widespread. But also if your quality is not good, Instagram automatically filters you out. It doesn't organically spread you more, spread your account profile more, because that picture is not something which people will like. It assesses on its own. So you have to take these small things into consideration. I have purposely not put the statistics because they're way too shocking. So this picture, for example, many people tell me that we don't have a ring light. How do we make it work? You don't have to have a ring light at all. Just a simple window in your house is enough. I'm sure we have one window in all our houses. Just stand next to the window. Do not click a picture when you're standing, when your back is towards the window, just like the picture on the left here shows. Make sure that you're standing opposite to the window. Like, for example, this ring light is my window. I'm standing opposite the window. Let the light come in and hold your camera here. I have often explained this to people because people stand with the back, which will only give you a silhouette because there is no light coming in at all. And the another point that I want to tell you all is the photo courtesy option. Now, in case if you want to make photos that you don't want your picture to be in, which is fine, you can take photos from different websites. I'm going to tell you all the names later. You all can click photos of other objects. Make sure if you're taking photos from other profiles or other websites, or even photos of your friends who've, you know, if someone else has clicked it. If you're an institutional profile, or if you want to give off a good image of you being very professional, it is extremely important to give photo courtesy. As you can see, this simple photo that I've put on here, I had just typed on Google, the good light versus bad light picture, and this came on in one of the Google images. I have written the photo courtesy down because I am very strict about plagiarism. Whoever it is, whatever picture you're using, make sure you give them credit. Otherwise, not only is it illegal, but it also shows a very bad picture on you, what kind of a person you are. Like Sabeel said in the introduction, again, it is a reflection of your personality. And in the beginning, on the first day of the 6-day webinar, starting off, Niranjan Hiranandani sir had said 85% of our communication in the next 3 years is going to happen via social media. So just imagine how big a role your digital image plays on social media, because you're building an image, right? Everybody here, we all the institutions, all the profiles, everybody is building an image. We are all trying to make a good image of ourselves by posting good pictures, by writing good English, by making sure the grammar is correct. So all of these things matter, but don't forget the photo courtesy. These are the absolute light basics, but now I'm going to show you a video on how to do good lighting photos. Because we are talking in an institutional background, I'm going to show you a photo of a book that my assistant has clicked in different lightings to show you all how we can actually implement this. The video has no audio. I'll be talking you through the video, talking to you throughout the video, sorry. A quick hands up in the chat would be good. Are y'all with me? Is everything making sense? Okay, so my question to my team, yeah, not just in life, but in pictures, what is your focus? What do you want to show that you want to highlight? What do you want to highlight? So low light versus sufficient light, because remember, you don't need to have huge ring lights or studio setup to click a nice picture. I'll show you another example of the picture that I clicked just 2 days ago on my phone and I posted it. So low light examples are here. You can see this, how dark it looks. Of course, editing is magic. We can do a lot in editing, but I want you all to focus on clicking good pictures to begin with. This is another dark picture. Also, I would like to bring your attention to the background. We will talk about this further down the line, but make sure that you're putting in a little bit of an effort when you're doing something, like we write, when we are writing essays or when we are doing other stuff related to studies, makeup, anything that you're doing, we always make sure that there's, you know, enough good things around us. Even when you're cooking, we make sure that if we have things ready and if you're making a cooking video, we make sure that our platform is clean, everything is ready. Similarly here, you can't just keep it anywhere, the book, for example. You just need to make sure that the background is neat. Whatever you're covering, that much space needs to look like a beautiful canvas. Here, literally, the book has just been kept on the floor and pictures are being clicked. Zero effort. Now, good lighting, but also a little more effort. So you can see the background is suddenly very beautiful, very picturesque. There are colors in the photo because you want to make the photo look beautiful. This is one way of using colors. The other one, now here we are using a lot of props, okay? So there's a pen, there's a piece of paper, there's a phone, and the photo is taken from top angle. We are going to come to angles in a bit. But you can see that there's a little bit of effort, not like 100% book video or book shoot effort, but this is good enough. And we are talking about basics here. So once we get into the habit of clicking good enough pictures, we'll get to a, you know, better and best pictures stage. This one. So again, here you can see the reflection of the window on the phone. You can see a different angle of the picture. There's a little bit of a plant there. And the background is again the same colorful background, but there's enough lighting. The whole video, this focus, the focus of this video is to show you we can click pictures of the same book in different lighting by just moving our subject from one place to the other. The book was earlier kept on the floor. Now it's kept on a table across the window. That's it. Simple. All right. So I'm going to have a quick look at the chat section and see if y'all are with me. And we are going to get back to the slides. Me up till now? Yes, yes, yes. Okay, fantastic. If y'all have any questions, please feel free to ask me. I'm going to go on to my presentation. All right. I have talked about photo courtesy. I have talked about lighting. I have talked about how y'all can make sure that the surroundings of the picture are also nice. For example, in this case, the woman has a plain white background wall, which is fine. As long as it's not messy, as long as it's not dirty, a little bit of effort goes a really long way in giving a very good image, not only of the picture, but also of the person posting it, of the person clicking it. Now, of course, editing can change your life. I have, because of my clients, I have had to make absolutely dull pictures look so bright. But the whole point is, why do you want to waste your time on editing instead of putting in a little bit of effort on clicking a good picture? Now, if y'all are in a situation where you have clients or where you have photos that are already taken and you have to use those pictures, then editing can really save your life. Now, whether it's an Android, whether it's an Apple, any phone, any technology, in spite of Android, Apple, whatever phone you have in your hand, I can guarantee you when you click on the picture, when you click on edit, there is a little bit of option, you know, here or here. There are a few options that let you play with colors, that let you play with exposure, brightness, contrast. Now, before we proceed, I have to warn you. This is a time-consuming procedure. Whether it is Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, if you are not willing to put in effort it shows. If you put in effort, it shows. Whatever you do, it shows, okay? It reflects what state of mind you were in and how careful you are or how careless you are about what image you're creating. So you have to put in effort no matter what you do. Editing is a very flexible thing. It's a very flexible tool. You can sit and edit for 5 minutes and make the picture look beautiful. You can sit and edit the same picture for 5 hours and still make it look beautiful, because there are various stages of editing. Remember, this is a basics masterclass. I'm just talking about the absolute basics for beginners. You have to make sure that you're starting off with the basics and not overwhelming yourself with like, oh my God, this is too much, I can't do it, and you leave it. That is not the aim of the session. The aim of the session is everybody uses Instagram. Everybody posts photos on Instagram, which are, you know, good looking, which have been clicked well, which have been edited well. Now, editing does play wonders. Sorry. For example, this picture that I showed you all in the video earlier, here, I showed you the difference it can make. Low lighting, sufficient. This has again been clicked on a bed. Sometimes you want to put something which has not been put a lot of effort into, you know, it's okay. But even in that, a little bit of effort is important. A bad picture was taken, but it was made, it was, you know, edited to look decent on the right hand side. So how did we arrive at this decent stage? I'm going to get to right now. Again, I'm showing you another video, which I'll be talking you through it. Okay, which I'll be talking through to show you the difference. Again, what is the focus? Of course, basic, okay? We are talking about absolute basic editing, whichever phone you have. So I have spent, before I show you, I have spent a lot of my life being scared of just thinking what people will think. And once I learned the magic called editing, all the fear went away, because I just was so confident that nothing or, you know, nobody can challenge me, because now I know how to transform a basic picture to a nicer picture. In, for example, on iPhone, you also have that auto button. If you press that, it automatically adjusts exposure, brightness, everything. And you just have a basic edited picture with just one tap. And I'm sure that is also available on Android, because I've seen that on some people's phones. Now, Instagram, I hope you all are taking notes, people. Instagram has three basic ratios. So one is landscape. The picture right now, what you see is vertical, right? The exact opposite of that is landscape. You can post a picture horizontally. I'll be talking you through to show you examples from my Instagram profile. The other is portrait and the other is square, okay? So here, what we are doing is we are first taking a picture, bringing it into PicsArt. Take notes. It's a free app. It's a very useful app. Okay. So PicsArt just makes pictures awesome, like it says. It keeps telling you all to pay and all of this. Just ignore all of that. Take a picture, the one that we clicked, for example, right now. And then you can choose in the ratio. You have to ignore the ads. Okay. Then you can go to tools and go to ratio to select the size that you want. Okay. Look, when you look at the bottom, you can see on the extreme right, there is an Instagram logo and it says square. Next to it is portrait. So life is that easy. An app tells you everything about the picture, whatever size you want, just click on it, fit it. You can see it became a square right now. And then we are adjusting it. We've put it in square. We've downloaded the picture. All right. So we are clear with the size of the picture. Now we are going to edit the picture just a tad bit. You see, the auto button was pressed now. I can show you this again. So I opened this picture in my iPhone, and then on the bottom, there's an auto button. So if you click on that auto, it automatically changes all the ratios. So if you have no time or no interest, you can literally press that and your job is done. Or if you're interested in learning a bit more, you can have fun playing with those settings. So play with exposure, play with black light, play with brightness, contrast, shadows. I personally have found so much joy after I've learned editing. It's just beautiful. You can see there. This is how we edit. It's downstairs. It's below here, below the picture it's showing, right? I've screen recorded for y'all so I can explain literally everything. That is highlights, shadows, contrast, brightness. So you can literally choose how much you want what. Of course, I can talk about hours on each of this because we do that when we sit and edit pictures for our clients. But it's beautiful. It's very therapeutic because you literally feel like you're creating magic. Also with the sharpness and definition, if you're iPhone users, the sharpness and definition features just brings out even more, the texture of the picture. So you can actually see the wrinkles on the face. You can actually see the bedsheet covers, you know, the lines on the bedsheet covers if they've not been ironed. So the sharpness really brings out the sharpness in the picture. Again, these features are also available on Android. If not, they are also available on PicsArt. So do not feel like if you don't have the right phone, you can't edit well. That is not the case. So what Vignette does, for example, I know this is not a photo editing masterclass. What Vignette does is basically it creates a halo of darkness and it brings light to the center. So you can see there's a halo of black, dark situation and the book suddenly looks a lot more brighter. It's the center of the attention. It's in the center. It's grabbing your eye, okay? If you all want, I can show you all this again. Yes, just look at the Vignette bit now. You saw that? And if you take it on the other scale, it brings a halo of white, lot of bright light into the picture. So you can really play with editing when I talk about editing. So before edit, this is how the photo looked. And after edit, this is how the photo looked. All right. So that was good lighting and editing for you, the absolute basics. I would like to request a quick show of hands in the chats, in your comments. Just let us know how are we doing. Are you all enjoying this? If you all have any questions before I proceed. The next bit is about angles, but.
Bhavana.
Yeah.
There is few questions. Can I?
Absolutely.
Yeah. How to click a bokeh mode picture in which we are jumping and the photos clicked and give a bokeh effect?
So we are getting into the details of editing. If you send me this question, I'll answer it on Instagram because I have more to cover. But please send me this question. I'll quickly cover it.
Okay. Then yeah. Another regarding how can a writer grow Instagram account?
Yes, Ritika sent me that question. I'm going to cover that towards the end. If I don't, you can remind me again.
Okay. How we can earn from Instagram for each post?
Tell yeah.
These are the questions just now came up.
Sure. Absolutely. Are we clear with the photo clicking, lighting and editing? These two parts, the absolute basics?
Yes, Bhavana, you can continue.
Okay, cool. Now, Ritika, I'm going to request you to talk to me in a few minutes. I'm going to talk about angles now, okay? And then Ritika, I'll speak to you, just a heads up. Okay, so we've seen the photo clicking part and we've talked about the editing part. These are the absolute basics. Of course, each part requires a detailed session and I have just touched the absolute basics and I'm, you know, going forward. Now, when you click pictures, you have to keep in mind the angles. And as a joke, many people recently in the recent times have been talking about how when you click a picture holding your phone here, it shows your double chin and all of this part. As part of this, the Daily Mail in the UK, a newspaper, spoke about this and said that there was a viral trend happening where people were not showing. So earlier people only used to show the good angles, right? The new trend was where you expose your ugly faces, your ugly angles, so to speak, and you embrace every part of your personality, which is fine. This is the joke, and this is what you can see happens. Now, I see a lot of people, especially in my family, my mother and father, they hold the phone like this, and they say hi on video call, they talk. You have to remember when you're holding a phone, you have to check where is your camera situated. If my camera is situated here, I need to bring the camera angle at my eye angle. Okay, basic, absolute basic. Right now, here are my eyes. Here is my laptop camera angle. Okay, you all can see my fingers. So when you're clicking a picture, even if you're an absolute novice, if you have no experience, that's fine. Just make sure when you're going to the camera and the camera opens, you have to click a picture at your eye level or just a little bit below it. The higher up you go, remember your face looks thinner because you're taking the camera angle upwards. The lower you go, and I'm talking about the face here, but the subject can be literally anything. It can be a book, it can be a pen, it can be anything. You have to play around with angles to find out what you like. You just can't click one picture with any angle and say, this is the best, unless you're a very successful photographer. So if your camera is at your eye angle right now, what it is now, I have clicked my picture and this is what it is. Okay, this is my eye angle picture. So the basics of angles are, there are two different types of angles that you need to keep in mind. One is top angle, one is eye angle. Just don't get into the details of anything. If you're very scared of angles, remember whatever you need, whatever picture you want to click on, press focus, the small square that comes on Android and Apples before clicking a picture so that the camera knows what is your subject. Click on that and then make sure it's either at the eye angle if it's a face. If it's not a face, just make sure whatever angle you want, you're happy with that. And if not, experiment. Please click the same picture from different angles and then just go through the gallery and select whichever you like and think about why do you like what you like. Because you need to get that for future, right? Again, I'm going to show you another video about angles, which will make this more clear. What's your focus, of course? Okay, so before we were adjusting the light here, I'll show you this again. When the video starts, you can see this small button with the sun on it. We are adjusting the light here because it's kept against the window. You can see the window there. And even then, in spite of bad light, you can still adjust and bring more brightness into the photo just by clicking the focus button, just by tapping the focus button on the camera. All this needs attention. So when you're clicking a picture, be very aware of what all features you have on your screen. Just know your device very well. And then you can see we took the brightness up and suddenly you can read the name of the book. And here you can see very random, not readable angles, the angle that is this particular angle. Again, at the spine of the book. So literally no composition. Composition means what all is in the picture, what is your frame, what all is getting covered, what all is getting out of the picture. So if you think about it, if it's a square, everything in the square, it's also called flat lay. Everything in the square looks beautiful when you put in a little bit of effort because you're arranging things in the picture, right? You're clicking, so you're the authority. You're arranging what looks how in your picture. So these are a few examples how, even if you're putting effort, even if there's a pen, there's a phone, there's a plant, even then we are capable of clicking bad pictures because we are not, you know, putting our all. Okay, so these are the examples of bad angles. Like I have seen such pictures on Instagram. I can neither read the title here, nor I can understand the background, nor I can understand what is the person trying to tell me by posting this book. What are you trying to do? And please do not post bad pictures because that creates a very bad impression of you. So just be very careful with the basics, absolute basics. This I showed you all earlier as well. Here you can read the title of the book. You can see the other things around. the options in your phone, if you have a portrait option on your phone, whether it's OnePlus, whether it's iPhone, whether it's Android, many phones have the option of portrait where other things get blurred out. Only one thing stays in focus. So explore your device. I beg you, please know your device in and out very well, because there's a lot of magic in there. For example, this is another angle. We saw one top angle, right? So one top shot we saw, and this is just a very basic eye level angle that you can see. And you can read the book, the title of the book. You can read the author's name. You can look at surrounding images as well. It looks neater, you know, it's pleasing to the eye. For example, again, this one. If your photo gets many likes, and many people ask me, how do we get organic engagement? How do we get organic likes and comments? You have to understand, you have to start with the content. If what you're putting out is not good, people are not going to engage with you. If something is adding value to their life, if something is making them smile, if something is just making them happy, if they see, oh, it's a nice picture, they'll tap it and then move ahead. You know, people have become very strict with what they're tapping, what they're liking, what they're engaging with. Not everybody is engaging with everything, even if they're seeing things. So you have to take into account that unless and until your content is good, not much, you can't go further ahead if your content is not good, basically. And for content to be good, you have to put in effort. All right. Now, I am going to move on to my slides again. All right. We are going to go to feed, stories, and recently the reels option. But before that, can I please speak to Ritika? So Ritika and Sabil, I think I'll stop screen sharing for a bit. Okay, Ritika and Sabil, hi. You two take care of the BTTC official Instagram, if I'm correct.
Yeah.
Right. Now, please tell me your experiences about working on Instagram.
Okay. Sabil, you want to say?
You start first. And I'll...
Okay. All right. So, when we got the social media accounts from our seniors, we were at around 350 followers on Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
And the one thing that we noticed was it was not a business account. It was a personal account. So the first thing that we did is we converted it into a business account. So we got access to insights. We had promotions, we had the call button, the email button. And that became so much easier for us because, you know, we learned that we're catering to more of millennials than Gen Z or Gen X. So we figured out what do they like what clicks with them. Mm-hmm. So we came to know that they like interactive stories more than, you know, liking our posts. They like IGTV. So we started all this, I think, around 24th March when lockdown was announced, approximately around that date. And from that date up till today, we have grown by 100 followers at least. And we have an amazing social media team. We have Salsa Veel Sheikh here. We have Bhavika Gyanchandani who handles Facebook. So we understood via the insights, what do they prefer? And we also understood the hashtags that they liked. So we started reading a lot of social media blogs. We started figuring out, you know, what do they prefer? And the first thing was, yeah, like I said, Instagram stories and hashtags. This is what clicked with them.
Can I interrupt you for a minute, Ritika?
Yeah.
Okay. So these are my other two points that I specifically wanted to talk about. Only after talking to Ritika, I'll come to you, Sabil. One is hashtags. If y'all are taking notes, please write this down, people. Hashtags are supremely important. 30 hashtags per post are allowed. Now, why do we use hashtags and which ones to use? These are the two key points that I want to talk about. One is hashtags basically are words without any spaces. Okay. So when you're searching for something, for example, if I put hashtag BTTC official, wherever that hashtag has been used, it will show me all of those. So instead of just looking at BTTC official's profile, even if today after this session, I put a picture of, you know, I put a screenshot of this session and I say what an extremely interactive session it was and I had so much fun. And in my hashtags, I put BTTC official. So anybody else who's searching for BTTC official will also have a look at my post and will come to know that, okay, I had conducted the session. If students on their individual profiles put pictures and they, you know, use the hashtag BTTC official, basically it just becomes a one big family of that same hashtag, which has been spread across different profiles. You know, that becomes a very easy searchable method. Now, my team members, one of the team member who's not working with us anymore because he was way too crazy, he would always use this hashtag generator apps. I can give you 10 of those app names, people, but I personally do not believe in those apps because those hashtags that are being generated are very US based, whatever hashtags are, you know, trending in America because those apps are based there. And B, it's also very difficult and competitive because you can't just use follow for follow, like for like, and those hashtags. And, you know, you can't hope to be in the top few hashtags because that's just silly. I personally believe in making our own hashtags, being a little niche, but also being a little generic. For example, when you use BTTC official hashtag, you have 30 hashtag space. Okay, so make sure you use the entire 30 hashtags. The more searchable you are, the better it is. BTTC official, BTTC students, BTTC council, BTTC teachers. So just with BTTC, you can create 10. Okay. Now, where are you based? You're based in Bombay. Bombay colleges, best Bombay colleges, top Mumbai colleges, Mumbai college students. Okay. So again, 10 you can create around where you're based. Now, third and most important is be a little more broader in your search. One is extremely specific with your name. Again, with your geographical location. Third, be very broad, like your university is coming up. So make your university hashtags. You're based in India. Make sure you are counted among the India's best. Look at other hashtags that other institutions are using. I personally have been following so many institutions and I like the way they form their own hashtags. Because not now, you have to think long term. After 1 year, after 2 years, after 5 years, your hashtag family will grow so much because you are making those hashtags. And people are constantly checking what are you using, your full stop, your comma is being assessed. You know, when I use the hashtags, people comment, oh, your hashtag was interesting. So people actually read all the hashtags. And I love creating hashtags. So you can be a little niche, be a little generic, but then also put those hashtags in your stories and tell people, hashtag us and let us know. Use this hashtag and let us know. Make it a trend, you know? So make it more engaging. And when you said your 100 followers has increased, Ritika, from March, you said you've taken up, right? So we are in July. Let's say your 100 followers went up till June. It took you 2 to 3 months, right? Once you reach 1,000K, which happened with my YouTube, and I have learned this from many creators, the first 1,000 are extremely difficult. Sorry, can you please mute yourself, whoever it is? Okay, so the first 1,000 followers are extremely difficult to get because people follow, unfollow, unless and until you're adding value to their lives, to their time. You know, you're not taking them for granted. People are very strict about what accounts they're following. But the first 1,000 people, if they stay with you, you have to understand that you've done something good. And for that, you have to put in a lot of effort. Your pictures shouldn't fall out of place. You know, for example, I see pictures, half the text is missing because we don't know the ratio that whether it'll fit in square or not. You know, half the text is blur. So just your feed needs to look beautiful. About organic following takes a lot of effort. It takes a lot of time. I have personally seen YouTubers, fashion bloggers who put up posts 3 times in a day, every single day. Just imagine the amount of dedication and hard work. And today I have seen where they have grown. I've been following them since 5 years, watching their journey, and I've been seeing where they have reached, you know. It's a lot of effort. Unless you're willing to put in a lot of effort, you cannot expect miracles because Instagram memory is a real thing. If you Google it up, and I'm saying this because I have myself attended so many Instagram masterclasses, Instagram has a memory of its own. The more active you are, the more your account becomes visible to different people. If you just make an account and sit there, nothing is going to happen. It's so similar to life. You have to put in a lot of effort. Sabil, now I want to, you know, ask from you, what do you do for Instagram, BTTC?
First, in the beginning, we were like, you know, we want to connect our audience with the creative execution. Mm-hmm. So that
what does that mean?
Creative execution is like, you know, like every day, like last time as we experienced Guru Purnima, that day we have made a video for all our professors and we posted on the social media. So that video has so many viewers and the best like and most approachable, like on Instagram it was the highest rate. So that time we think that we have to do it many times, like every situation, every something happened to our college, something like we are doing interesting or something, that we have to post in a very creative way. So that attracts the audience most. So for that, I and Vithika and all my social media team, we were discussing, and we will next time do a lot more than Guru Purnima videos we have made.
Right.
And also to reach our audience, it's very important to post stories, continue stories. So last time that we engaged with our students, our professors, Balani sir, and all our faculty members to, you know, connect to us on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, so that, you know, people will see our profession and they also feel like, yes, we are there in BTDC still. So that is the more very important motive for us.
Right. So
execution is very important, I guess.
Absolutely. Now, again, I'm going to talk about a few points that I had actually kept for towards the end, tips and tricks. But right now, to help you with your BTTC Instagram, I'm talking very specific here, but people who've joined us on Zoom, people who've joined us on YouTube, you can replicate the same thing with your institution or with your personal life, with your Insta handle. This applies to everything. The absolute basic. When I went through your BTTC official Instagram page, I checked and checked, but I did not get a proper summary of who all is at BTTC, you know, like the profiles of the teachers. And just to give you all a few ideas on the content that you can make, because content creation is a lot of hard work, it will make your life easy if you first pick up all the staff, you know, working staff, admin staff, every staff, if you take a nice picture, and then you can make a post with those 10 slides in it. One post with 10 slides, I hope you know that. And you can post their qualification, since how many years they've been working with you all, what is their role, what do students say about them. And if you want to break it up, you can also break this up into different, you know, parts. For example, when Teacher's Day is approaching, you can say, this is what the student has to say about this teacher. And that way your entire feed can look very beautiful, because we talk about threes, you know, in Instagram, we talk about threes. It's a row. You can keep one row for each teacher. So this way your rows fill up very beautifully and your feed looks beautiful. For example, we often make sure that when we talk about something, we first begin with, for example, a Sindhi artist. So many people don't even know who Bhagwanti Nawani was. So I first put her picture. Then I put a different picture with all the movies that she's acted in. Then a different video of her songs. I can put all this into one, but you have to take care that the information doesn't get overloaded. And if you break it up, that also helps your feed look beautiful. So that is just one idea. You can put posts of your faculty, of your principal, of the students, of the activities that you've done in the past, which I see you all regularly upload the activities. But when it comes to staff, you can... when you put each picture, like one teacher one day, for example, it's Raju ma'am's profile tomorrow. Okay, so we put 10 pictures, one picture of Raju ma'am, another of her qualification, another of her role at BTTC. Then you can put the same thing in stories and then tell people what has been your experience with this teacher. Share with us in your comments. You can put up a poll. Do you know this ma'am? You know, the more engaging content you create, the more Instagram stories become widespread available to other audience who are not even following you. And this is, again, Instagram memory. The more beautiful it looks, the more organic shares it gets. Am I making sense, Sabeel? Okay. Any other questions, Ritika and Sabeel? Okay. Now tell me...
We don't have, but we'll let you know if you...
Sure. I just want to ask you all, what are the kind of DMs that you get? How good are you all with engaging with people, with replying to people's comments, with replying to people's messages?
So we get a lot of reactions to our story. That's like the first thing. So we like their reactions. So, and that's instant. So either I do it or Sabil does it. Then we get inquiries about admission processes and, you know, the next academic year or when is the next webinar. So the things that we're sure about, we reply instantly.
Okay. And so again,
if we are not sure about, we ask our faculty members, we ask the teachers, and yeah, then we reply to them.
Sure, yeah, absolutely. Again, y'all can, in your bio, y'all can put more details. You can update your website. You can put the link towards that website. You can put link to a YouTube channel, which you've done today. And for further details also, you can have templates. So what that does is, for example, a two-liner. Hi, thank you for your message. We are really grateful that you've replied, or whatever you want to say. And, you know, our college is not open. Our premises will not be open. Whatever you want. Thanks, Team BTTC. So make sure you look very professional in your answers. And I'm saying this because the accounts that I follow, I receive a very standard reply from all of them with exact grammar and punctuation. Because again, we are building our image, right? And that image creation is very important. So when I talk to BTTC versus when I talk to some other university, the replies that I get, it's so easy to just screenshot and make fun of, right? So make sure that you have templates ready so that for every answer, you don't have to think. Ritika, Sabil, you can send it to your own DMs and, you know, have that answer ready. Few different answers ready for different questions. That'll also make your life easy. And liking and, you know, engaging is one of the most important things. The other thing that I want to talk about is content calendar. Do you all do that by any chance? Okay. So for me, what I have learned over the years is, what I do is, and I'm going to give a very BTTC specific example. The day your college had opened, whatever the big days for your college are, Teacher's Day, Diwali, Holi, whatever you all celebrate, your annual function, college ka, just make a list of all the big days, all the big events that you would have usually celebrated in college, but because of lockdown are not celebrating. Generally also, you should have a calendar of all the functions, right? And all the public holidays as well. Now, what happens is when you make this calendar, then you break it down into month-wise calendar. Every month, two, three people, whoever is on the content team, just get together, have a brainstorming session on what date, what will you post? Okay. So I personally have a content calendar for my Instagram and YouTube. I look at the festivals. I look at the days that are important. Then I think to myself, do I want to post on this day? Do I want to talk about this? If you don't, just be quiet, forget it, let the day go off. Okay. But if you want to talk about it, like for example, Guru Purnima, instead of making content in such a rush, just one day or 2 days ago, oh my God, Guru Purnima is coming. You know, instead of that, if you have
2 hours.
Wow. Okay. 2 hours. My God. So if you have it planned, your stress levels will not go high. You will prepare better content because people have been given time and deadline to send in their content, and you will have enough time to edit it beautifully. Okay. Because whether you make a 2 hours video or a 2 weeks video, the effort shows. Okay. The rush versus planned one, it shows. So making a content calendar is one of my biggest tips that I can give you all, because that just makes your life so much easier. Okay. We all have calendars at home. Just sit and think, what all do you want to make? I personally make a monthly calendar for all my channels so that people who follow me on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, don't think I'm posting the same thing. You have to put in different effort for different channel. Okay. And I know that's a lot of hard work, but that is what life is. Okay. Any questions up till now? People, there are a few things in the chat. Sorry. Is there any ideal ratio between followers and following? Yes. So good question. I just had a quick look at it. Ritika and Sabil, if y'all can go through questions and send it to me on my WhatsApp, that will be useful. So followers and following. Thank you, Ritika. Followers and following. I see many accounts who have about 10, 15, 20 followers, and they are following 1,000 people. Please don't do that. Just please don't do that. You can follow as many people as you want. But if it's a private account, that's okay. If you're making a business account or a public account or an artist account, it gives a very bad impression that you don't have enough followers and you are following so many people. You can have a separate private account for that. Okay. You can follow many people, follow different accounts from a separate private account. But the account that you want to show it to people, just make sure the bio is very beautiful, very crisp. It's, if you're putting in a link, the link is working. Make sure that the link is not broken. And the feed has to have some good effort. Not every feed needs to look very beautiful and artistic, but basic good photos. Once you start with good photos, you will get to better pictures. You will get to better planning. But don't overexhaust yourself by just saying, oh my God, I'm not going to post unless I have a beautiful picture. Because then we'll just keep waiting for Godot. Okay, that'll never happen. Okay? The other question is, how we can earn from Instagram for each post. Okay, the earning thing. Unless and until your account is a business account, please make sure that you're not, please make sure you're not making your account into a business account unless needed. So if you're not selling anything, don't make your account into a business account. There are other accounts also, for example, artist account, Ars Hindi Film Festival is a community account. These all accounts also give you insights. They give you analytics. Use those numbers. How many people are visiting you? Because the thing with Instagram business is what I have learned from personal experience. Unless and until people are looking to shop or look at business profiles, your profile does not get forwarded to many people. In organic search, it gets blocked because you are a business account. So you have to make sure your account is not business unless you're actually selling something. Okay. The second point is how to earn money from Instagram. Money is a very later thing. The first and foremost thing is followers. If you do not have a good following, and by good, I mean even 1,000 to 10,000 is fine. Because many brands, many different institutions these days are looking for people with organic following, with genuine following. If I have 1,000 followers, but there are just 2 likes for my picture, it shows that the following is not organic. There are many bots, robots available that people buy. And once you pay them, you get likes on all your pictures and the 1 month contract ends. Sorry, all those likes go away. So that becomes very visible. People are actually looking for people who have organic engagement with the followers, who comment to people, who write, who reply to people, and who the pictures are liked by people. Okay, the pictures are looking nice. So unless and until the following is good enough, the money is not an issue. Until and unless you reach a good following and you have good engagement. No matter what you do, the paid promotion thing is not easy because you don't have a good following. Once you get the good following, you can pitch into your brand. You can tell them, this is how disciplined I am. This is how many times I post. This is the engagement. They'll ask you for your insights. And make sure you don't give your insights away to anybody very easily, okay? Sorry, I'm just looking at the questions. How... Okay. From each post. Yeah. Earning from each post is a far off level. First, work on building your content. Make sure your profile looks good. Your feed looks good. Krunal, I hope I answered your question. Krunal Contractor. Sri Lakshmi Narsimha, any ideal ratio between followers and following? Make sure your followers are more than your following. If you follow 10, 20 people, your followers should be at least 100 people. You know? Yes, Priya ma'am, sure. You can ask questions towards the end. How can a writer grow an Instagram account? So that's a very good question, Muskan. I go through such a panic attack when I see budding writers have improper grammar. If you want to give a professional effect to whatever you're doing, if you want people to look up to you very seriously, if you want people to follow you and not unfollow you after they follow you, you have to make sure that your content is worth it. Follow writers like Jay Shetty, Rupi Kaur. There are many writers. I can give you more names on in a DM. But the main point is, if you're writing, make sure your punctuation, make sure your grammar is correct. If your sentences are not proper, what is the point of posting? Because there are already millions of accounts with millions of followers getting good content. If you're new into the market, if you're going to add some value to people's lives, make sure that you have got your basics sorted. Now, talking about grammar, people, there is this app called Grammarly. I don't use it. I have good grammar, touch wood. But make sure you use Grammarly, the free version. I'm not requesting everybody to go out and purchase and spend a lot of money. The free version also does a lot of basic correction. Microsoft Word does a lot of free grammar and sentence correction. Even the spelling correct is there. So all of these apps are there. I know it is a little more effort. Instead of just writing and posting, you have to first write it on an app, check the grammar. But that is what you should be willing to put in. Okay. If you're not willing to put in the effort to write captions or write good posts, then please don't write bad and make people unfollow you. The number one tip for writers is to make sure that their language, vocabulary, their punctuation is correct. Because I look at grammar of everything. So people who are out there who are trained to, you know, have a certain eye for mistakes or something, they will not even recommend your accounts to other people. And if your writing is good, remember, even one shout out can help a lot, okay? If your writing is good, you can request other writers who are established to give you shout outs. And before giving shout outs, they will go through your profile. They will see how hard you worked. They will look at your feed and then they will recommend you if they think you're worth it. So make sure you're worth it. How to make instant auto responses. Instant auto responses on Instagram, as far as I know, is not a thing. But if you want to give quick responses, have a few templates ready. I'm reading a few questions, okay, that have come in. Make sure you have your templates ready of answers. For example, hi, dear, thank you. Hi, dear, hi, there, whatever you want, depends on the level you want to show of being approachable. So thank you for your reply. We'll be back with you shortly. Thank you, team BPTC, you know, whatever. Have a few such templates ready so that when you get some questions, you just literally copy paste. And it also gives a very professional image. Yes, iPhone XS Max. Didn't know it has so many inbuilt editing options. Anis Fatima, you're welcome. Even I have not explored my phone to the fullest. I just know the basics of my phone. And I'm so happy with the basics because it gets the job done, okay? So whatever phone you have, irrespective of an iPhone or an Android, just make sure you know your phone very well. The editing, the camera, all the types of photos that it can take, very useful to know your phone very well. Can you talk about Instagram live sessions that gained popularity? Ashish, okay. Goofing around with each other. So the thing is, during this COVID-19, many celebrities started going Instagram live. The reason they did so well was because they are already verified. So verified accounts have a lot more access and have a lot more reach compared to non-verified accounts. In order to get there, again, you have to work very hard. But Instagram live sessions, I suggest only those accounts should go who have at least more than 500 followers, okay? If you have only 100, 200 following and only 5 or 10 people join you, then I personally feel it's a waste of a lot of effort. Make sure you start off with 5-minute, 2-minute videos. Make sure people are engaging with those videos. They need to appreciate your content to listen to you. Now you're listening to me for about an hour and a half because you think I'm adding value to your life, okay? And you think that because I have worked so hard, my past record is good. When I was starting out, no one would have given me the platform to talk about 1.5 hours for a platform that I have not worked on, okay? It's very simple, absolute basic math. You have to work and create a good track record. Good question, Dr. Kalpana Chauhan. Can we use regional language? That was one of my main tips and tricks for the content. Dr. Kalpana Chauhan and other people who think that English is the only language ahead. No. We can use regional language. We can use any language we want. Now you have to first have a self-talk. Decide what kind of audience do you want. I'll give you first my example. Then I'll give you another example of someone who writes in Marathi. First example, Sindhi Film Festival. So my account is about Sindhi stuff, right? But there are many people who follow me and there are many people like me who cannot read and write in the Perso-Arabic Sindhi script. Sindhi script looks like Arabic script. I haven't gone to a Sindhi school. I don't know to read and write the language, but I know to speak the language. So what I do is I speak in Sindhi on Instagram stories. I speak in Sindhi on YouTube videos. But the photos and videos that I post on Instagram feed, they are in English. My captions are in English. So I consider my profile as very bilingual, okay? There is Sindhi content, English captions. And YouTube has a lot of Sindhi talking, again, English captions. This is one example. Second example, I'm not trying to promote anybody here. Please get that very straight. Aditya Thakre was in my college. He was my junior, St. Xavier's. Aditya Thakre's account I was looking at yesterday, just, you know, to go through what type of content people are creating. He has huge captions, like very long, 2-3 paragraph captions in Marathi, and then two dots, and the same thing completely beautifully, grammatically, correctly translated to English. So the caption is about a page long, you know, 2-3 paragraphs in Marathi, 2-3 paragraphs in English, and Marathi and English both absolutely beautiful vocabulary, no grammatical errors. So if you want to go bilingual or just one language, regional language, you are absolutely free to go and pursue whatever language you want. I also have the Hindi keyboard option. So you can write in Hindi. I see so many people doing that. I also know of a few Punjabi and Bengali accounts. If you want, I can send you more. Just DM me on Sindhi Film Festival. I'll send you all the details. I know of many Punjabi and Bengali accounts who only write in that script, you know. So whether it's Marathi script, Hindi script, you can write any script that you want. You just have to choose what kind of audience you want to attract, okay? Because the audience will follow, you should know to read the language, right? Whatever you're writing, they should know to read. If you're not approachable, if you're not understandable to people, then what's the point? I hope that answers your question. There are many Spanish accounts also that I know who only write and talk in Spanish, and they have huge following. So following is not a problem. As long as you're clear with what language you want, you're producing good content in that language and making sure that you're answering people's questions. You know, the other day I was following an Ayurvedic doctor. She was going live with a Spanish doctor, and the Spanish doctor's Instagram account was completely Spanish, very alien to me. But in her Instagram live, the Ayurvedic doctor that she was talking to is a friend of mine. So she was first talking in Spanish in the live, Instagram live. Then she was translating into English, the same thing. And she was also talking to my friend, the Ayurvedic doctor, in English. Whatever answers she was giving, the Spanish woman was again translating her answers into Spanish. So yes, absolutely any language is fine. It's a lot of effort, and that is fine. You just need to be clear and consistent with your content, okay? Okay, Devjani, very good question. How many ways on Instagram can help in teaching learning? I personally have been a teacher since childhood. I've been teaching. Stories is one of the most fantastic ways, because there are quick ways of doing it. One is poll. The other one is just DM me. So you can actually use the stories to ask people to, you know, ask questions on what topics would you like them to, you know, cover topics on. How many minutes videos can you do? Whatever people engage with, na, they will make sure that they follow that, because they have also participated in it. For example, how many ways stories on Instagram can help in teaching learning? When you are talking about teaching and learning, there are two different methods, right? One is the content that stays. So you can put that on your feed. People can come back and watch it. Other ways you can use stories is you can fix a date, fix a time, announce it beforehand. For example, 1 week ago, I'll say, on this day at this time, I'm going to go live and I'm going to talk about this thing only in my stories. You will not find it again. Okay. And then people will look forward to your stories. You can also put a clock there, set a reminder, so people can set a reminder and come to your stories at that time. There are extremely many, many ways of becoming creative. And on stories also, you can post so many things. For example, if you want to talk about teaching basic grammar. So on stories, you can start teaching about punctuation, nouns, verbs. And if people learn it, that's fine. If they don't, the stories are gone. Okay. What is the other question? I'm liking your questions, people. Top three tips to increase followers. Mansi, thank you for the question. Top three tips to increase followers. Be very consistent with your posts. Number one, you cannot post 10 photos every single day for 10 days and then disappear for 2 months. That's not how it works. If you want to post one photo, take a break of 2 days, post another photo, be consistent. If people see you regularly, they know you're very disciplined. if people don't see you regularly, you know, it's not a good image building thing. Second, make sure you're engaging with your audience. Whatever messages you're getting, accept the dirty messages. Whatever interesting messages you're getting, make sure you reply. Third and most important, make sure you tell people that you will create the content that they want, okay? If there is a specific genre that you're good at, ask people what would they like to see. And then create content according to what they want to see. But also make sure in that process, you don't lose out on what you want to make. Make it an interesting mix, okay? An interesting balance. These are my three top tips. Any other questions, people?
I think so far these many questions have come in. Once mm-hmm. they keep on coming in, I think Priya ma'am will ask them. Should we continue?
Yes. One last question I'm going to quickly answer by Narsimhan. Sri Lakshmi Narsimhan. Sorry. Hope you will cover more about hashtags in this session. Sri Lakshmi, I have already covered about hashtags. If you want more details, DM me. I'll send you my video answers. Sandeep Tavsalkar, thank you for your question. How to create traffic on your account? If your content is good, and again, I'm going to show you with an example. If we go to my Sindhi Film Festival Instagram, and I'm requesting you all this because I want to show you all something. Okay, so I'm on my Sindhi Film Festival Instagram, and I have 23 people who followed me right now. And that is because I spoke about it. I told you about following me on Instagram, but also you thought it was worth it because let's just look at the latest post, okay? This is a tipno. It's a Sindhi calendar, which has all the Sindhi festivals depending on the seasons, okay? Now, I posted a picture of this tipno last week. I hope y'all can see this picture. If y'all go to Instagram, it'll be easier, okay? This tipno, I clicked the picture near my window. I edited it. And then I wrote a beautiful caption. I took my time. It took me an hour just to click the picture, edit it, write the caption, do the hashtags, and to tag people. Don't forget to tag people. I'll talk about that in a minute. Now, my caption is not more than, 4 or 5 sentences? But all those sentences are well thought out. And towards the end, if you pay attention, I have asked, have you seen a tipno before? Do your parents/grandparents refer to this often? Tell us your tipno stories in the comments below. We are eager to hear. If you end your caption with a question, people engage because you're telling people to engage. People do what you request them to do only if they find it useful. Now, I received about 10 to 12 comments. I have a following of about 1,000 people. From 1,000 people, only 1% comment I received, 10 comments. Getting people to comment on your work is very difficult. It's a lot of hard work, but you have to keep trying because people will understand that you're genuinely interested. I was genuinely interested in the tipno stories, but I made sure that before writing, have you seen the tipno before? Tell us your tipno stories. Before that, I wrote a few lines about my experience of the tipno. So what I wrote as the caption was, first I wrote, what is that called? Because it's not a normal thing. People don't see it often. I wrote it, Sindhi tipno. Then I wrote, the mothership Hema Rajpal was sat with us yesterday evening during dinner and was telling us about Sindhi festivals and how differently we'll be celebrating them, okay? Because of the lockdown. And when I go, the picture has received a lot of love, above 100 likes. And my insights, my analysis say, this has been shared more than 10 to 20 times. And when people share, they further share. And you can see all the details in your insights. And that is very important because you have to keep checking what kind of pictures are people liking. Why are they liking them? Is that because you've used a certain hashtag, or is that because your captions are good, or is that pictures are good? You have to try and understand your audience. The other picture that you'll see, for example, here, the fair Sindhi girl, this one. This picture that I had posted, again, has been one of the best photos in the recent times. It has done so well. People have shared it, people have commented it, and people have DM'd me saying, Thank you for sharing the story. We still go through all of this. So when the question is about creating traffic on the account, coming back to Sandeep's question, traffic is not an overnight thing. Unless and until you do something that people like and people feel like sharing with someone else, there will be no traffic on your account. So you have to make sure your content is unique. You cannot just copy paste and expect people to like it. Unless and until you're adding value, you're creating content, you're putting an effort in the caption, you're using hashtags, and people know that, okay, this profile is for this thing. We are used to categories, right? So if I want to follow fashion accounts, I will follow fashion designers. If I want to follow institutional accounts, I'll follow BTTC, I'll follow HSNC. I'm clear with people. If I want to find inspirational people, I'll go to Ratan Tata, I'll go to Jay Shetty, I'll go to Rupi Kaur for poems. Okay, so you need to make sure people know what will we get from your account. Don't let people think about your account. Don't confuse them. Okay, so I'm going to continue with my presentation. Hope that was useful. A quick Q&A. And let's share screen again. But please continue writing your feedback in the chats and comments, okay? I'm receiving those. We talked about lighting, we talked about angles, and we talked about basic editing. Moving on from this beautiful picture. Now, Instagram feed, which means if you all follow me, you'll see that we put a lot of effort into feed, but there are other accounts who put a lot more effort into their feeds, okay? This thing that you see on Instagram, this is called feed for people who don't know. And the stories that you put in, which disappear in 24 hours, are called stories. But because Instagram is so smart, after TikTok was banned in India, just day before yesterday, Instagram launched Reels. Now, R-E-E-L-S, what are Reels? Reels basically, I personally think it's useless, but Reels basically are copying TikTok. You have music already provided and you can just put on any video, add music, and that's it. Your reel is done. So you don't have to hunt for music. You don't have to edit much. Everything is just ready-made. You have all the tools. You have to put them together. Now, how do you choose whether you should put Instagram stories, whether you should go Instagram live, what to put on your feed? Okay, there are these questions: which, when, how, why. Again, when I requested you all to make a content calendar, just like if you're a teacher, to make points of what you will cover in that session. Just like when you're a designer, you first draw. What do you want people to see on your feed? You have to think about it. How do you want to design your feed? And then when you talk about when, the analysis also tell you when are your followers most active. Because if you post at 3 a.m. at night when everybody is sleeping and your post becomes an old post when people don't even scroll, your post gets lost. It is important to post at a time when your followers are most active, and you can see that from the analysis. All the analytics are provided in the analytics button, if your account is artist or if it's a community account or if it's a business account. And then the stories question I had already answered when someone asked about content, teaching, learning. If y'all want more details, y'all can follow me. But the feed versus stories is a little important to be in tandem with each other. For example, when I spoke about when I posted the Sindhi Tipno, I also posted details. Festival is coming. I'm going to talk about more about that festival just one day before the festival in Sindhi language. And even your stories are shared. I don't know if you all know that, but for example, the stories, I put up these stories yesterday that I'm going to go live with. I put up on my Instagram stories yesterday that I'm going to be going live. With BTTC today. And I saw many people have even shared those stories. So whatever content you're putting out, you just need to make sure that you're clear if it gets shared, if it's okay. Or if it's not good enough, don't post it. and on feed versus stories versus highlights. There are some stories which I thought were very useful. So after I, after those stories had disappeared, I kept them in highlights. But for highlights also, if you make covers and if you write names of the highlights, it looks very, you know, clear and categorized. It shows you've put an effort. Feed versus stories, I wanted to add reel, but never mind, because it was just added day before. Now, Instagram Live and IGTV, it's important to know your audience. People, you have to know your audience. For example, if you might be seeing here right now, I'm constantly asking you all for questions. I'm replying to those questions. I'm engaging with you all because I don't want to feel like there's only one way communication going on. And how are y'all engaging with me? Y'all have followed me. I can see how many people are going through my feed right now. I can see in the analysis, people have liked a few pictures. So they are reading my captions. It has to be a two-way communication because I'm not this big leader here and I have a mass audience following. That is not the way. I see it as a big Insta social family, you know, my Instagram family, my YouTube family. That's how I see it. Whatever you ask, I reply. Whatever I say, you engage with it. And it's a two-way communication. So you have to know your audience. I haven't posted anything on my Instagram, IGTV and Instagram Live that I'm sure my audience will not like. You know, and how do you get to know that? By seeing the number of likes, by looking at the comments, getting an idea of what the audience wants. I regularly do polls because I love doing polls. So for example, on Sunday, another food blogger account had put that Sundays are for Sindhi curries. So I just reposted that photo. And in the next Instagram story, I asked, is it a Sindhi curry Sunday at your home also? Yes or no? Simple. And just by keeping yourself active in stories, your account becomes more visible. It organically grows. People come to know about you. All right. I am approaching the end of the session. But before that, I want to talk about business versus artistic account, monetization and more. Now, you have to understand what is the difference between artist account and business account. I already touched upon it before. If you're not selling something, don't make it a business account. If you're doing something that really interests you, make it an artist account. If it is something relevant to the community, make it that. For example, BTTC can be an institution account because it is an institution. And the category in which you put yourself in, remember that category will help you grow ahead. Okay. So if you put yourself in an institution account, when people look for institutions, your account will come on the top search list, okay? And you have to be very clear with that. So if your account is not business account, if you're not selling anything, there's no point of putting your account in business account because there are no orders being placed with your account. And because there is not enough order activity, your account will not come in the top search list. I hope I'm making sense. Please tell me in the chats if I am making sense and if y'all have any questions. And I think this is going to be the last round of Q&A. A quick 5-minute Q&A before I tell you the app names and the final suggestions. Ritika, you're very sweet. Thank you for saying amazing. Okay.
Can I take the questions, Bhavna?
Yes, ma'am. I need a water break. So just a minute, I'll sip on some water, okay? I'm going to stop the screen sharing option for now. Yeah, please send me the questions on WhatsApp. I'll answer them in a minute.
Should I dictate or you will answer?
Either way is fine by me. Whatever suits you.
Yeah. Devjani Chakravarti, he's wanted to ask, do suggest maintaining different account for personal and professional use?
Mm-hmm.
Suggest maintaining different account for personal and professional use.
Mm-hmm. That is a question?
Yeah. He wondered whether he can opt for different accounts. One for personal and one for...
Absolutely. Okay. So I'm going to again give my example first because I find that easier. I have two accounts, The Sindhi Girl, on which I'm very unfiltered and very personal and I talk about whatever I like. And the other account is Sindhi Film Festival, where things are very filtered, professional. I take care of how the feed looks. Okay. You don't have to have two accounts. If you're not a social butterfly, if you don't like sharing everything with people, if you're very clear about what you want to put on your feed, you can just have one account. That's absolutely fine. I'm not suggesting anybody to have multiple accounts because I know that is a lot of work. As long as you're clear with how many people you'll follow, why you'll follow them. Because remember, people can see your followers. The people you follow, the other people who follow you will be able to see your followers list, right? So nothing is hidden. And people are constantly judging everybody, right? So depending on whom I'm following, people are like, oh my God, she follows makeup brands. She's very, you know, into makeup and, you know, all of that. So it depends on what kind of image you want to create. For example, from my Sindhi Film Festival account, I follow a few film accounts because that is most relevant to the account that I have, okay? And if people are checking my followers list, I don't mind they having look at who I'm following. And then we have a third account, our team. Sometimes we need to check if we post this, how will it look? A separate private account, we just post it and see how is it getting posted or not. And buffer account, which is very private, to just see how things will look. But if you're very clear about what account you want, one account is more than enough. Just maintain it well, okay?
Okay, Sri Lakshmi Narasimhan, she wanted to know should I maintain the same timing for posting on different dates or changing the timing often will be effective. Good question, very good question.
Now what happens is with every single account the timings are different because your followers are active at different times. When I was living in London for a long time, the timing of my active users was usually on weekends, that too in the mornings. Okay, so 9 to 12 was my active timing. Your analysis shows you everything. If you want details, you can follow me. I'll DM you on how you can find out when are your users most active. It's a very simple method. It's in your analysis insights. And when I moved to India, now my active following, I see my users are online from 9 to 12 p.m. I like sleeping early. So I post at 9 p.m. and then I switch off my phone and I'm like, I'm done for the day. Because Instagram is also a job, right? Whether I'm doing it for my clients or whether I'm doing it for myself, it's a job. So I make sure that I post when the window starts. So 9 to 12 p.m. At night and then I'm off. I post at 9, I'm off. And then I have also seen on weekends, the people in where I live, Bombay, people in Bombay are very active during the afternoons. So you can see those windows. It's a 3-hour window that Instagram shows you. These are the days, these are the times when your followers are most active. So when your followers are most active, you can post a lot of stories. You can post a lot of photos on your feed. And you can also post more than one time in a day. You know, there are no restrictions. Again, another example that I want to tell you is if you look at top content creators, just in India, I'm giving you a very random example. They are like, I sometimes feel that they need therapy, but they are so obsessed with not disappearing from people's stories. They post something, just a random picture, just a boomerang of clouds, you know, every hour, just so that they are present in the stories. And by being present in the stories, people are checking your stories, right? So people also have this extreme obsession of people not forgetting them, and they overdo it and they post every hour. So you don't have to post every hour. You can post twice or thrice in a day on your stories. Just make sure that you're very consistent with your what you're doing. And also don't lose your mental sanity. Okay? Instagram can make you keep working on Instagram all day. Don't do that.
Another question from Dr. Ramchandra. I am a teacher. How can I use this to my students and in my classroom teaching?
Fantastic question. With COVID, all the students are sitting online. Believe me, they are. All the teachers are also sitting online. The thing is, students don't want to show that they're following teachers because that's so old school. The teachers don't feel like they are good enough because they don't know how to hold a camera. So it's a two-way effort. The teachers have to learn to become very cool, okay? And if you become cool, your students will follow you. Now, first and foremost, if you're new as a teacher, then it's going to be a little difficult. If your students already know you, then they will suddenly find, oh my God, his feed is looking cool. Wow, what a nice picture. What a nice angle. Nice, you know, stories. So just make sure, get a stand or something. It's a 200 rupee stand. I got it off of Amazon. I just put my phone on it and I keep my phone on eye level. I do my Instagram stories and I take the phone off of the Instagram stand. Or just hold your phone in your hand at your eye level. Stories. Talk to people. How are you all doing? This is how I am doing. Start with extreme basics. Put a picture on your feed asking what content would you like me to make? Because I love making content. Let people know what you genuinely enjoy doing and ask them for your feedback. because out of many followers, I'm sure at least a few followers will reply to you. Okay.
Yeah. Now the another question from Prapti Vyas. Two questions. If I have good amount of followers but don't know what kind of content to engage my audience with, what kind of content should be post?
The second fantastic. Part, sorry, can more? I first answer the first part?
Okay.
Okay, sorry, ma'am. Yeah. That's a fantastic question, Bhakti. We all are in the same boat. For example, I love fashion. I love makeup. I also love writing poems. I love doing so many things. What you can do in such a scenario is make a content calendar. Write it down, people. Make a content calendar. So, for example, on Sundays, you can post about this. On Mondays, fashion. On Tuesdays, makeup. On Fridays, skincare. Just divide it in your head and then plan accordingly. You don't have to give up on other things, focus on one thing. You can do everything that you want. Just make sure that people come to know that you are an interesting mix of a person, you know. For example, I love doing cooking videos. So once a month or something, I post a cooking video and that's it. Because cooking videos, shoot and edit is also a lot of effort. So you can shoot, you can do whatever you want. Even if you're not clear, you can cover all different aspects. And then when you're consistent with this multiple different aspects thing over a few months, you will realize that you're enjoying this more than that. You're enjoying this over that. And slowly, you know, it'll filter down, or maybe if you're loving everything, you'll continue that way and your following will increase that way because people will come to know, wow, she's so multi-talented. Okay.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Second part, what are the Instagram insight or analysis tools? Can you mention some of them?
Yes. So first and foremost tool is Instagram itself. You have to keep checking your own insights, own analysis, because giving permission to outside tools is not something that I recommend. I do not like installing other apps, giving them access to my data and then telling them to analyze it. Instagram has made our lives so easy just by giving all the tools to us, you know. Just go through when you're standing in your profile, when you're in your profile, just go through insights right here. You can see the word insights in the center next to promotions. It is so much insight. I personally charge people, all my clients, for, you know, going through their insights and planning accordingly. It's a full business, okay? So if you become good at it, you can earn money also. And you actually come to know how many people have watched it, how many people have shared it, at what time they have watched it. Go through the details. The second best option that I'll tell you for insights is you have to stay up to date. For example, day before yesterday when Instagram released Reels, I'm talking only about India, huh? In Brazil and everywhere else, it was released before that. And we are still in the trial version in India. You have to stay on top of the news. For me, Instagram is business. I have many clients for Instagram. And if people who are watching me on Zoom and YouTube, if you want me to do your digital marketing, I'm available. But the point is, you have to stay on top of the news. You need to know what is happening when. All my verified customers who have a blue tick, they got access to Reels at 6 p.m. And the other people got access to Reels at 7:30, the non-tick people. Okay. So if you are verified, you have more access. If you know the news, you know more. If you want to learn how to get more insights, please read up on blogs. Please read up on legitimate YouTube channels, Instagram channels who tell you more about it. And if you're feeling very lazy about it, then I can recommend you a few more apps who will do your analysis in the DMs, okay?
Lakshmi Shekhar want to know, how can we use Instagram for arts and craft, like creative work? How do we reach a large crowd?
That's a very good question, Lakshmi. Am I saying the name right? Is it Lakshmi?
Yeah, Lakshmi.
For arts, creativity. I attended a session even last week on digital media and how to promote artists. Look, everything boils down to what content you put out. If your content is good, people will follow you more. I also know many artists who have only 100 or 200 following, but they sell their art pieces. People like it. If your work is good, if your work is neat, and if the pictures of that work are good. I might be a great painter, but I don't know to click good pictures. So I'm not going to do well, okay? If you're using Instagram, you have to understand, I'm coming back to my first slide, it's all about visual medium. It has to please the eye, okay? So if you're an artist, just make sure whatever pictures you're posting, make sure that they look neat, okay? They look clear, not blurry pictures, not just any surrounding pictures, put a little bit of effort. And also, if you want to make money, you can sell your art. It will have to start small. If you charge 1 lakh, 2 lakh, just to begin with, that's not how it will work. Art pieces also get sold on Instagram. Or you can also have a small business account associated with your Instagram account. For example, you can have a Shopify link, or which is that other website. I'll send you the names if you DM me on Instagram. I'll tell you more details. But there are these websites which let you sell things, right? So if you put link to that where you can actually sell your art, and if you're not into selling, you can just keep an Instagram live, for example, start your live video, and you can just start painting, you know. You can tell people, come and paint with me. So you can have a live painting workshop. You can put on some nice music, have a candle burning for 15, 20 minutes, half an hour, you can paint something. People can also come and join you. They can paint in their houses, and it'll be a mutual session, you know. So people will find that relaxing. Whatever you're good at, make sure you let people know that and invite them to join you in that. Thank you.
Yeah, another question. Satyanarayana Raju wanted to know, what is the major advantage of Instagram than Facebook?
Thank you. What a good question. Now, according to my statistics, which I have not showed here today, according to my statistics, 80% of the audience between the age range of 18 to 25 is on Instagram, not on Facebook. And 80% of people who are above 40 are on Facebook and not on Instagram. So do you see this huge gap? 18 to 25, 30, all these people are on Instagram. People above 40 are on Facebook. So whichever audience you want to reach towards, you can use that app.
Then Bhuvaneshwar also, you wanted to know, if I make my traveling videos, can it work to engage people, and how to create creativity?
Fantastic. So traveling videos do very well on Instagram. Actually, there are so many ways you can put traveling videos. You can put behind the scenes also. Behind the scenes also, people love it. Traveling videos, again, depending on your budget, you can buy a GoPro, you can buy a camera, you can buy a phone. Phone also does fantastic things. Whatever video you're making, traveling, cooking, painting, teaching, make sure of two things. Your camera is clear. Before using my laptop today morning, I cleaned my camera with a nice dry cotton towel and I made sure of the angle. Right now it's kept on a huge long stool and it's on top of that. And ring light is behind it. So whatever video you're making, traveling or otherwise, make sure the angle, camera, and lighting, these three things are your pillars. They are very clear. Then comes the focus. Are you going to talk? Are you not going to talk? Is your audio going to be clear? If there's going to be music, no music, you decide all of those things. But whatever video you make, make sure if you're editing the videos, cut out all the unwanted things, okay? For example, if I'm walking for 1 hour and I'm saying, okay, people, now I'm walking towards this. I say that one line and I walk and I show for a few steps. That's fine. Don't keep the entire 1 hour walking thing, okay? Just be very creative. Don't waste people's time. Make it a very interesting, beautiful video.
Yeah, Sri Lakshmi Narasimhan, she wanted to know, can we hashtag famous celebrities, movie actors or sports people for our products? Is it professional?
I think it's not. Also, that shows a very sad situation because you are using other people's name to promote your name. And what will happen is, unfortunately, those people will never see your products. But the fan pages around those people, they will start following you. And is that the following you want? You know, you have to be very careful with what you're doing because that has a lot of, it has a chain effect. Whatever hashtags you're using. So if you create your own hashtags and if you use other general hashtags, for example, travel blogger, artist, painter, love colors, me time, music therapy, whatever surrounding your work, if you use those hashtags, you will get those kind of people who will actually be interested in your work, you know?
Again, on educational, regarding education, Virendra Kumar Patel is asking how to create an interesting educational feed on Instagram stories.
Beautiful question. Fantastic. The question is very broad themed, and that is why it allows me to answer in a very different manner. So for example, I have done my bachelor's in English literature, master's in English literature, and my research is on Sindhi cinema. Okay. And I'm giving you this example for a reason. if I were a teacher, if my account was only teaching account, what I would personally do is first I would talk about me. I would talk about what I'm good at. So my qualifications, how I love grammar, how I love talking to people, how I think I have good leadership skills, how many courses I've done, where all I have taught. But coming to the action part, I would ask people, what all would you like me to teach y'all? This is all that I can teach, you know, grammar, sentence construction, Shakespeare, American poetry, whatever I've studied, cinema, I can talk about Sindhi cinema, I can talk about Hindi cinema, I can talk about alternate cinema, experimental cinema. I'll talk about different topics. I'll ask people what would they like to see, but I'm not going to wait for people. If people don't reply, that's fine. I'll go ahead and I'll start making content which I enjoy. So I'll make a content calendar and I'll start by writing. First, I'll cover the basics of grammar. Next month, I'll talk about sentence construction. In the third month, I'll talk about essay writing. And I'll write beautiful quotes. I'll give examples of good versus bad. I'll give examples of what people generally use if they are wrong and then what they are correct. You know, so I'll make my feed in a manner which will reflect what I'm good at. And following that, people will come and follow me based on that. Okay. So if people like it, then they will tell in the comments, oh, this is fantastic. Please do more of this. You know what I mean?
Bhavna, last two questions.
Yes, ma'am.
It's a general question. Many participants wanted to know what is the security features, how to keep account privately, and how to keep accepting follow request. Can you give messages to only few people? Is there any option so that we can keep privacy setting only for certain followers?
Fantastic question. So you all have to know this and understand, the minute you put out any photo on Instagram, whether your account is public or private, you lose all your control over it. The minute you're posting anything on Instagram or any other channel, if you go through the Instagram details when you make your account, the copyright of the photo that you post is no more yours. It becomes that of the Instagram, okay? So whether it's a private account or a public account, make sure whatever you're posting, you're very clear about it. Because once you post, the copyright is not yours. It's of the channel on which you're posting. Now, whether it's a private account or a public account, it's up to you how you see it. Many people do this gimmick of keeping their account public for a long time, then making it private, you know, and when it's a private account, people are curious to know, oh my God, what is in that account, you know, and then they send a lot of requests. Then you make your account public and all those requests get accepted and your number goes up. Basically, I'm going to circle down to the same thing. It is about the content. This private public game playing thing is for teenagers who have a lot of time. If you're looking into a very professional account, make sure your content is good. If you want to keep it private, that is totally acceptable. That's your choice, not a problem at all. The people who will want to follow you will follow you no matter what, whether it's a public account or a private account. And there are going to be stupid people who will send you rubbish messages, whether it's a private account or a public account. You have to learn the art of blocking people. You have to learn the art of reporting stupid accounts, okay? It's so much fun. I can see Ritika smiling there because I'm sure she does that. So yes, no matter what account you do, focus on the content. And when it comes to security, there's an entire tab of security. When you go to Instagram settings of your profile, for example, I'll show you right now. Also, thank you for everybody who's following me on Sindhi Film Festival. When you go to here, when you go here, settings, insights, activity, name tag. So even your activity gets saved. Okay. What time you're logging in from, which phone you're logging in for, how long you're staying there. Everything is being noted and you have a detailed activity on security. So you can actually report accounts. You can block accounts. It's a lot of fun. Don't worry about security because you're anyway losing all the control when you're posting photos. So just be clear about what you're doing, how you're doing. And if you have more questions, I'm available on Sindhi Film Festival DMs.
Yeah, yes? There is no more questions, but I want to tell you that in YouTube, there are more than 100 thumbs up for your session. And all thank adjectives you. They have used, very informative, wonderful, excellent, nice, and
thank you.
Interesting, informative, and all that. And thank I can vouch you that you have engaged each and every participant from the beginning to the end. And you have talked about many things which everybody who is having an Instagram account, they will follow it. Or if not, everybody today, they may start with a new Instagram account. And you wanted to share some apps, you can do that now.
Yes, ma'am. Just last, I'm going to share the screen for one last time. But people, y'all also, even restricted account is possible. Ritika, that is a very good point. Thank you, darling. Many people have asked me many questions. I have tried to reply to everything. But ma'am, thank you for your comments. I really enjoy helping people. So I think that shows. I'll share my screen for one last time. Okay. People, y'all can see my screen, right? Okay. Priya ma'am, you can see my screen, right?
Yeah.
Fantastic. Now, I am going to suggest a few apps. Tomorrow is my YouTube session. Of course, for YouTube also, I'll suggest a few apps. Today, I'm suggesting for Instagram. But you have to remember, these all are time-consuming things. You have to have a mental dedication space for it. So make time. Don't do it when you're stressed because that will show. App suggestions. First and foremost, the app that I showed you in the beginning of the session, PicsArt app, which I told you is free. I like to keep it simple. I use a few apps, but I make sure they are good apps. So PicsArt is one app, PicsArt. PicsArt is one app which can do wonders. It already shows you the sizes when you go to the ratio, and it helps you crop. It also gives you a lot of effects. I personally don't believe in skin smoothing and all, so I just keep my skin as it is. But whoever wants to do magic, PicsArt also does paid promotions. So once you get to a certain point, PicsArt will pay you a lot of money if you teach people how to edit. That's not why I do it, but I like using this app. I've been using it for many years, only for basic things, just for just for the ratio and a few effects that I want to give. I want to show some sunlight somewhere. It's a beautiful app. If you want a masterclass on that, we can do that. Go on.
Yeah, I have a question.
Yes,
what people are not photogenic. They don't feel like, they don't like to show themselves on screen. You know, will the teacher be called as overdated? If the teacher is not, you know, is not comfortable to show the screen, show the face on screen, so is she called as overdated? Or how do we get rid of the feeling of being conscious of yourself on screen? So it's happened many of the time.
That's a very beautiful question, Sabil. I have 10 minutes left. I'm just going to say this. The whole looks thing has become so huge because of social media. It is extremely sad to see that. But having said that, when we as people in general, for example, when teachers go to school, right, they put in a little bit of effort. They make sure their hair is done. They look good. Just basics, absolute basics. I'm not asking you to have a makeup masterclass on when you're coming online. Absolutely not. Just absolute basic. Make sure you're looking presentable. If my funda is, if this is how I'm going to go and meet someone, it is okay by me to look that way on Instagram. If my morning face is not something that I'll go out in, I'll not put that on Instagram, you know? It's a very basic choice that we are making. And when you talk about teachers and what students think of them, the students have enough brains to understand that teachers are here for knowledge, okay? I remember how my school teachers looked even today, okay? I remember very clearly. I remember which teacher used to wear what sari and how she would dress up. Because when teachers teach, we forget how they're looking. We pay more attention on how they are talking. But the first little bit of an impression, the first 2 minutes, you know, when the students are just settling down, when the teacher has begun to start talking, just those couple of minutes are important to make sure that you have their attention. So I would like to request all the teachers and all the people who are not good with their phones, just make sure your camera angles are clear. Don't show them half of your neck, half of your ear, half of your head, because that's not what you do in real life. You come like this as a person in real life, in front of someone, right? So just make sure that is how you come online also. This person who does Chanakya Niti, I'm forgetting his name, I can DM you. He also is a very good teacher. And sometimes I just go and check how he's doing because he's a friend of a friend. And just the basic angles are fine. You know, you don't have to look like a hero, have makeup and hair done and all those things. No, just look basic, look clear. And, you know, camera has to be clear, audio has to be clear. Make sure the angle is good enough. That's why I covered angles today. All right. Am I clear?
Yeah.
Okay. Now I'm going to show you all one last video because Instagram stories we were talking about. I gave you an example of PicsArt for your feed. Now I'm going to give you an example of a story art. Again, we have dedicated apps for making beautiful stories. People take notes, people take a lot of effort into their Instagram, okay? Because they're making money, so they're putting in effort. This is an example. So this is what my assistant has made. It's a screen recording. She makes beautiful stories. I love it, and I love learning from her. So here's an example for your story. So photo editing with frames and other props, okay? The app is called Story Art. You all can write it down. Look, there's a name here, Story Art, SS. You see this? I'm pointing my mouse pointer here, all right? Now see the magic. We are back to the books, but you can literally create anything. Okay, so what Instagram Stories usually does is you can put one photo, right? When you're clicking or when you're uploading. But in this, you're editing in such a way that you put two pictures, three pictures, four pictures, you decide. You can choose the colors. Just have fun. Just watch this video. So she's adjusting these things. She saved it. It literally took less than a minute. Then she's going to Instagram and posting it. Okay. Now on this also, remember Instagram also has filters. Now she'll go through the filters. Paris, Oslo, Lagos, Melbourne, Jakarta. That's it. Done. Okay. I'll show you a few more examples. So I gifted her this for a birthday. And she clicked three different pictures of it, put it in a very beautiful layout, and wrote the text on top. It's finally here. Again, on left hand, she wrote Korean skincare. And at the bottom, she tagged me. Cindy Finn Festival, thank you for this. And you see what a beautiful layout it is. In just one image, you're covering three images, so much text. So if you put in effort, it'll look beautiful. And this app is also free, okay? Story Art. Simple coffee, it's a paper mug. But see how beautiful the picture can look. One is top shot, one is normal shot. Again, this is another book that she was reading. On the top, she has put up the time, two different book images, front cover, back cover. And then she's written, finally, I'm done reading the tastiest mystery ever, okay? So this is a little bit about how you can have fun with your Instagram stories. All right, and back to my presentation. For more, we are available on Sindhi Film Festival and The Sindhi Girl. I'll be more than happy to have you all. Whatever questions you all have in the DMs, of course I'll answer. And I want to thank you with all my heart. Please make sure you take a picture of this and tag us, Sindhi Film Festival, and just, you know, give us a shout out in your stories if you wish. No force, all right? Thank you very much, people. I had so much fun. I'll also take a picture, just one second.
Okay, there is no more questions now. Already you have taken up all the questions. I think now we are going to wind up. Balani sir, if you want to tell anything. I call upon Nikita Soni for...
Yes, Priya ma'am, I'm very much there on the platform. And I have watched the entire episode. And I'm very happy that Bhavana has done a wonderful job. She has covered the entire story of Instagram from A to Z. This is what is for me. I'm a new learner. And I'm not so active on Instagram. But the way she has shared some of the tips with all of us, I believe that the entire team of Bombay Teachers Training College student volunteers will must have noted down all those things and they will implement it so that as far as the important aspects of educational programs that we are organizing and that we will organize in the future, they will post it on all our social media channels, especially Instagram, And then as she has suggested, as an institution, we should be very responsible for the kind of posts that we are going to create. Those should be very authentic, real, and the language should be absolutely clear. And I think we should be very simple the way she has advised us. We cannot do with a lot of experimentation with it. We had to be very simple. We had to be truthful in all our endeavors. And we should also be continuous, present on all our social media, I think, channels. And there are many more lessons that we are going to learn in the future also. And Bano will be always there with us to help us in getting trained, you know, how to, we can say, meaningfully communicate to the larger community. So I'm very hopeful, and I believe that this session will be helpful to all the participants who are there since last 5 days supporting us with their presence on the YouTube, and the way they have given us the feedback. We value their participation. We value their responses. And sincerely, we will remain with them all the times. And I'm quite thankful to, no doubt, Bhavna is already there. It's my daughter, my girl, and all the faculty members, all children are my children. I really love them, the way they have been religiously taking this platform ahead, educating, communicating to the larger family. And I'm equally thankful to the entire BTDC family, each and every faculty member of our family, and all other associated students and all the stakeholders, people from TSEC especially. I'm thankful to the principal, G.D. Thambi sir, who has collaborated with us, Madam Edinburgh, Professor Monica Tolani, the four talented children. Girish is there, Pallavi, Meet, Harsh. They have really contributed a lot in making this webinar series a grand success. We will cherish all these memories of your association with us, and we will keep it, you know, all those memories at our bottom of the hearts, always for sharing a wonderful time with all of us. I'm also thankful to the organizers, Dr. Meenakshi, Dr. Raju Taleja, Dr. Priya Pillai, Vice Principal Dr. Mandeep Kochar, senior faculty, Dr. Rajija, Dr. Ansari, Dr. Neelu Verma, the most talented, Dr. Lumna Mansuri, Dr. Manisha Tyagi, all who have put in best of the best efforts and always supported us in all these endeavors. I think we will continue this journey. It's a wonderful journey. Over to Priya ma'am. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, sir.
Please excuse me if I have forgotten any of the names. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your kind words. And these compliments are motivating us for further doing good things for reaching out to the community. Now I call upon Anikta Soni, our student, to give a vote of thanks.
Thank you, ma'am. A very good afternoon to one and all. It is my privilege to have been asked to propose a vote of thanks for today's session. A webinar of this dimension can't happen overnight and needs meticulous planning and execution and an eye for detail. I cannot thank each one enough for the involvement they have shown and the willingness expressed to take on the completion of work beyond their comfort zone. I, Nikita Soni, on behalf of Bombay Teachers Training College and the entire fraternity of management here, extend a very hearty gratitude to our resource person, Ms. Bhavna Rajpal. It has been a pleasure to have you as a resource person. We thank you, ma'am, for all the efforts you have taken and for sparing your valuable time with us. To briefly sum up, Bhavna explained about the basics of Instagram, how to check good pictures with proper angles, lightings, editings which can change your life, its effects, how do hashtags work, also the content creation and how to attract maximum viewers. checking of insights, etc. We have been fortunate to have TSEC as our collaborating partner. Thank you for being collaborative and supporting our endeavor in this lockdown situation. I thank Girish Chawla, Pallavi Vaswani, Meet Merchant, and Harsh Lohana. I sincerely express my gratitude towards our Honorable Principal, Dr. Bhagwan Balani Sir of BTTC and Dr. G.T. Thampi of Thadamal Shahani Engineering College for a very effective collab with relentless hard work, dedication to make this webinar a great success. I must mention my profound sense of appreciation to Dr. Raju Talreja ma'am and Dr. Meenakshi Lath ma'am for organizing this webinar. I also take this opportunity to extend my sincere thanks to Priya Pillai ma'am for guiding me and encouraging me to propose vote of thanks for today. I would also like to thank all the volunteers who were the backbone of this webinar and the ones who tirelessly work on the forefront of all the time. Thank you, Sabil Sheikh, Zubia Sheikh, Juveria Ansari, Urmi Cheda, and Jacinta Cotino. I highly appreciate their efforts. This webinar would not have been possible without the support of technical team. I thank BIAP team for making this webinar a great success. Last but not the least, I thank the wonderful audience who actively participated and cooperated till the very end. You all have been truly amazing. We hope to see you all soon tomorrow at 11 a.m. for the topic YouTube 101 by Ms. Bhavna Rajpal. Stay tuned and have a great day. Thank you so much.